दिस इज जेवीएन डॉक्टर विशाल सक्सेना, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स एंड स्टेटिस्टिक्स इन जयपुर विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द मॉड्यूल नीड ऑफ सैम्पलिंग एंड क्राइटेरिया फॉर द सिलेक्शन ऑफ गुड सैम्पल्स. दिस सेशन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द कोर्स रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी एंड बायो स्टेटिस्टिक्स and under the program of B optometry and BPT, sixth semester of the university. And all we know that this session is very very important. That's why it is included in every course, in every course, every program of the university and as well as other universities. It is also a part of the research methodology and just studied in the course of PhD coursework. So in the today session we will just focus on the what are the needs of the sampling and just what should be the right criteria for selection of good samples. First we understand what is sampling. Sampling is the way of just selection of a sample and from a population. So just because we cannot just find out the results from our population, the size of population is much large and the results cannot be estimated by the population. So just we have to make the selection of samples and this process is called sampling. And samplings are of various types and so it is very important right from the beginning of sampling process that we should know what are the important points of selection of the sample and what should be the criteria for the good samples. So in the today's session we will take slides and by these slides we understand here what are the important points, criteria for the selection of good sample and why the sampling is needed for the researchers. So we share some slides. So needs of sampling in research methodology. Sampling is used in practice for a variety of reasons such as sampling can save time and money and because the population cannot be estimated, it is a large size mass and therefore we cannot estimate the results by the population and therefore to save the money and time we do the process of sampling. A sample study is usually less expensive than a census study. Census study means if we have to study whole the population, then it is called a census study and therefore it will be much expensive as compared to the study of sample. Therefore sampling is needed there and the sampling process produces results at a relatively faster speed. Sampling may enable more accurate measurements for a sample study if it is generally conducted by trained and experienced investigators. So very important point means the sampling should be done by the experienced persons and the trained persons, investigators, because in that case the sampling will take less time and it would be much cheaper and the process can be conducted rapidly and with the good results, with obtaining good results. Sampling remains the only way when the population contains infinitely many members. So it is important and the sampling is only the way, only the method by which we can get the results. So sampling just contains infinitely many members. when the population contains many members, infinitely many members, then sampling is the only way. Next point is that sampling remains the only choice when a test involves the destruction of the items under study. So in the some cases when the test just we are applying here and just involves the destruction of the items under study, and the items are just destructed continuously, and only the sampling is the way by which we can just find our results, because the items are just destructed continuously in the study. Therefore, sampling is only the way there. Sampling usually enables to estimate the sampling errors. It is very important point, because when we do the sampling, then the sampling is the method by which we can estimate the sampling errors, like standard error and the other errors, like the type 1 and type 2 errors, and thus assist in obtaining information concerning some characteristics of the population, and therefore assist in obtaining information concerning because in sampling process there is a criteria and to estimate the sampling errors. So therefore just this sampling process is concerning about the characteristic of the population. So therefore sampling is a good method by which we can just estimate our population. Next is, what is sampling criteria? So it is important point that just we should know here what are the criteria for the good selection of samples before sampling, and when a researcher starts to sample, to collect the sample or just to do the sampling process, then just he should keep some points in his or her mind for the sampling. So we are dividing it into four parts. Like we can see there, first point is the goal orientation. They suggest that a sample design should be oriented to research objectives and tailored to the survey design and fitted to the survey conditions. So it means when the researcher just begin the process of sampling, then the point of goal orientation should be his or her mind, and it will suggest that the sample design should be oriented the researcher objectives, because what are the objectives of researcher, and then he should just select that the he should select the he or she should select the same the ways of selection of sample according to their objectives, and tailored to the survey design and fitted to the survey conditions, and he or she should be just keep the conditions, survey conditions and survey design points in their minds. Second point is measurability. A sample design should enable the computation of valid estimates of its sampling variability. Normally, this variability is expressed in the form of standard errors in surveys. So measurability is the point which shows that the sample design should enable the computation of valid estimates of its sampling variability. Normally, this variability is expressed in the form of standard errors in surveys. Practicality. This implies that the sample design can be followed properly in the survey. It means when sample design should be followed in the survey, then it is necessary, and for this it is necessary to complete correct practical and clear instruction should be given to the interviewer, because the researcher should just keep that point that he has to make a good sample, or he has to design the sample good. In the sense that the desired results will be obtained soon. So the practical conditions should be in his or her mind, and for this it is necessary that complete, correct, practical and clear instruction should be given to the interviewer, so that no mistakes are made in the selection of the sampling units, sir? Because whenever he or she should have the points in his mind, then definitely he will not make the just the points on which he or she can make the mistakes. Next point is the economy, and economy is a very important point because sampling is a big process and large process, and the economical economy is the very important point for the researcher. So finally, economy implies that the objectives of the survey should be achieved with minimum cost, and minimum cost criteria should be in the mind of the researcher, and effort survey objectives are generally spelled out in the term of precision. So survey objectives are generally spelled out. So main the points of the survey objectives and sampling objectives should be in the mind of researcher, because whenever he has a point in mind, then he can apply the right process for the selection of the sample and for the criteria of sampling. So economy is a very important factor for this for the way of sampling, and he or she should keep that point in mind. Sampling criteria is one must remember that two costs are involved in a sampling analysis. So there are two costs involving in the process of sampling, and the cost of one is the cost of collecting the data, one is the cost of collecting the data, and the cost of incorrect inference resulting from the data. So these are the two costs involved in the sampling analysis. One is the collection of data, and the second is of the cost of incorrect inference resulting from the data. So the researcher must keep in view the two causes of incorrect inferences. So always what are the two causes of incorrect inferences. Like one is the systematic bias and bias and the sampling error. Second is the sampling error. So a systematic bias results from errors in the sampling procedures and cannot be reduced or eliminated by the increasing the sample size. So we have seen this point, a systematic bias, which is the point for this the researcher must be should be alert for this point, that the systematic bias research that the systematic bias results from the errors in the sampling procedures and it cannot be reduced. This error cannot be reduced or be eliminated by the increasing the sample size. So he must he or she must have keep in the mind this point here, so that this kind of error should be generated in very very low quantity or just low order. So in this today's session we have seen that the need of sampling process and what should be the criteria for selection of good samples, and it is important for the researcher, for the investigator, keep some points in his mind before starting to do the sampling process, and because when he starts the process and just after the starting of the process of sampling, he will not be able to correct it. So therefore, before the sampling process, these are the points should keep in his mind for the getting better results. Now students are advised to just to study these points, to study this session very carefully and with concepts, and make some questions on there for just or how to write the answers for these this question of like need of the sampling process, and what should be the key, what should be the criteria for selection of good sample, and he or she just student should must understand the concept of this topic just with full knowledge, and because it is a very important part of the research also. So just I would like to complete my session today, and thanks for this session, and thanks for just listening to me. Thank you.